You do not accept the existence of a God, a divine prime mover, right?
No.
Now, the reason you don't is because you can't prove that there that such a entity or being or energy exists.
I can't, or nor can anyone else. There is no proof.
There is no proof that there is no... that there, so, therefore, you've concluded that there isn't one.
That's right.
You can't prove there isn't.
You are never called upon to prove a negative. That's a law of logic.
All right. You've got to be impressed with the universe. When you see order in the universe, this wasn't an accident, Miss Rand.
Oh, now you've got to give me a few minutes. What do you think would happen in a disorderly universe?
In a disorderly universe?
What's the concept of order? What does it have to do with the things which exist? If they clashed with each other, if there were contradictions, they wouldn't exist. There is no such thing as a disorderly universe. Our whole concept of order comes from observing reality. And reality has to be orderly because it's the standard of what exists.
Right.
The contradictions cannot exist.
Okay. Yes.
But the real issue here, as far as man is concerned, is that when you accept such an important issue as the creation of the universe, on faith, you're destroying your confidence and the validity of your own mind. It has to be either reason or faith. I am against God for the reason that I don't want to destroy reason. I don't...
Give us a chance, all right? We appreciate your zeal, but if you continue that, it's going to make it difficult for the other people to absorb what's going on here.
He says, how can I be against God? I'm against those who conceived that idea.
Tell us why.
Because then it gives man permission to function irrationally, to accept something above and outside the power of their reason, and superior to reason. Yes, you said it, I think, unintentionally. You said, so I can't wait to die and find out. That, I'm serious, is one of the results of acting on faith. You can't wait to get out of this life.
And what's wrong with that?
Because this life is wonderful, as you said. Because if you look at the universe, it's wonderful. And you have to use your life to the best of your understanding. If you go by emotions, not reason, it means you're going against reality. Something exists, something is right, and you say, no, I don't like it, because I want to believe something else. You, in effect, go by emotions, by your whims, not by reason.